Fastest dolls of all time. 30-minute dolls so we can play Frostpunk 2 in time for the sponsor stream today, okay? Which means we're skipping Poke Doku. No disrespect. 1950s New York, maybe? 1950s New York? 1950s San Francisco? I don't know. 1950s LA? Chinatown. It looks like the Big Lebowski, but it's not the Big Lebowski. This is Kingpin. I actually thought it's possibly Kingpin for real. This is Elvis at the Strand Club. Isn't this the dude from Mr. Show who got arrested for being at January 6th? No, this is Dylan Dermott. Christopher Walken. New York in the 1950s. This is called like King of New York or something. Is it That Thing You Do? No, I don't see Steve Zahn. I see Dan Giesling. That Thing You Do. This is Jersey Boys. Is this Jersey Boys? I got it, Jersey Boys. Okay, just being honest with you. I know it's about Frankie Valli. We get there. Dan somehow looks like all of them. I don't mean this to be negative, okay? This is Dan. This is short Dan. 100%. I could see a little Germa in here for sure. I could definitely see a little Germa. I'm pretty sure this is Steven Yeun. And then this guy honestly looks a staggering amount like my roommate from the first year of university, which is crazy to me. I know it's not because he couldn't act for shit, but like... Bartlett does kind of look like Point Crow, man. Not one-to-one, but I can definitely see it. I can totally see it, man. I've never seen Jersey Boys. It's about Frankie Valli and the Four Seasons, right? At 230 pounds, Mike Anderson rushed. Mr. Anderson, you have a choice. AFC team, year 2000, that was possibly good. Las Vegas Raiders, who were the Oakland Raiders at the time, was worth a try. Shai Gilgeous-Alexander spent his rookie seasons with this Western Conference team. Honestly thought he was drafted by Oklahoma City. I don't know, ball. He probably started with a team that is selling, the Utah Jazz. Okay, I don't know. The Clippers. The only non-American to win the U.S. Open was this South African golfer, Ernie Els. That's a gimme. The Mirage and Eclipse are produced by what automobile brand? Mitsubishi. Christian Bale, Kate Blanchett. Christian Bale is a given. Yeah, I think that's Kate Blanchett. You can just tell from the ears. Aged white cheddar. This bagged snack brand has variants like Cheddar Blast and Crunch Attack. Pirate's Booty? Oh, he's going off, man. He's locked in today. This controversial Netflix teen drama. My 13th Reason. Denzel Washington. John Q. John Q is about sieging the hospital so his son can get surgery. This rapper is known for Day and Night, Erase Me, and Pursuit of Happiness. Am I crazy to think that Day and Night is Neo? I am crazy for that one. Oh, Kid Cudi, that's a whiff. Why did I think that was Neo, man? That's an insult to both of them somehow. Oh, no. 76% of people got it. Who? What does Neo do? Akon is like, so lonely. I'm Mr. Lonely. Neo's featured on it? Oh, 'cause I'm so sick of love songs. So tired of Gleep. Yeah, okay. The lonely stoner frees his mind at night. Yes, dude. Yes. Yes, Geddy Lee. Sing it. Connections got me yesterday. Let me think. A pump, flat, slide. These are three different kinds of shoe. Mic, amp, mat. Silent letter at the end. Speaker. Mic, speaker, amp. Chair. Things you need to perform at your high school talent show. Speaker, chair, whip, leader. Positions in the motherfucking Senate, dude! You almost had me. Pump, flat, slide. Mic, amp, fire. Mule's an interesting one. Mule. Doug. Hype. Amp, hype, pump, psych. To get ready for something. What? What? You amp up, you hype up, you pump up. Fire up. Okay, so it's not get excited. What? You mic up somebody? How could you do this to me? How could you do this to me? That, because that's a connection, man. Pete, rearrange the letters, you get tape. He's right, you know. Slide. Types of whistles. It's types of guitars. Amp. Short form. Flat. Flat pump. Slide. Fire shoes. Maybe in Zelda. Doug shoes. Hype shoes. Hype beast. Things that are beasts. Pete. Pete. Matt. Doug, hang on. And Mike, homonyms for male names. Okay. Fire, pump, hype, amp. No, bro. Flat, slide, pump. Mule. Because, okay, pump and slide are together. That means that this makes a connection. Okay, I've never heard of a mule shoe, but by using matrix multiplication, get excited with up. Holy cow, that one was a disaster, but we get there. That was a tough one, honestly, because I think that like for hype up, like that category, there were like seven things that fit. That was a 5 out of 5 difficulty today. Ooh. And say, uh-oh. Game of Thrones. Bowls. Give a heads up. Like some credit card accounts. Not costing much. Cheap. Celebrated every April 22nd. Earth. Move to the music. Dance. Okay, so this Game of Thrones. Darts. I was colonial posting. Hawaiian high. Aloha. Make an allusion to. Refer. Reward for a well-behaved dog is a treat. Men's basketball star, Steph Curry. Could have gone worse. Could have gone worse, all things considered. Cascodal. What the hell? And I'm saying this politely. What the hell is Chantilly Croquembouche? 36 ounces of croquembouche. Whenever you buy seasonal stuff at Costco, it carries a premium not because it's Costco, but because it's seasonal. So this I could easily see because you might get it as a gift for someone. They can afford to charge you more. I think this could be as much as $19.99 in Canada. So I'm going to say $16.99 American. No, maybe I don't know what I'm talking about. $11.99. $7.99? Well, now if you give me this shit, like, I'm not going to be impressed. To be honest, it would be better for me if it costs like $21.99. Then I'd be like, oh, they put that kind of value on our friendship. What the heck is Chantilly croquembouche, man? It's just croquembouche? What is croquembouche? It's like French for like toad mouth or something? Pâté à choix from Costco must be cheap too. What is pâté à choix? It's dog food? Aren't you half French? Well, like my DNA is like probably like 95% French, but that shit did not get passed down culturally for whatever reason. Like it turns out just having the genes in your body doesn't teach you the language. I wish it did, man. I wish it did. Who knows what the fuck I'd be speaking like right now. I could be speaking perfect Minyanese. Azerbaijan. Decent. Better. Closer. Warmer. Kyrgyzstan. Cooler. Okay. Egypt. Adjacent. Libya. Adjacent. Sudan. No! Oh, lucky me. I didn't know Sudan bordered Libya. It's very close. I'd like to make a guess of Mozambique. You Nigeria? Oh. Are you Sudan? Double Sudan. I had to take the chance. Rwanda? Skibbity Uganda, Skibbity South Sudan. Yay! Well, it's like, how is Rwanda closer to South Sudan than Sudan is? Like, that doesn't make sense to me. Oh, because it's for distance from the capitals. Shut up, buddy. You can keep saying it. That doesn't mean I'm going to listen. I don't know what the fucking capital is, to be straight up with you. November 25th, 2016. It's a tough time for our nation. How about at the multiplex? This was like my 28th birthday. What were we fucking with on my 28th birthday? We were fucking with Moana. Pretty good movie. Warner Brothers had a little bit of a 39% bop. That, to me, screams Aquaman, a DC movie that had legs. No? Eddie Redmayne, Fantastic Beasts, 1. Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them. Walt Disney had a 23% fall off with Benedict Cumberbatch. That's got to be Doctor Strange. Before the Multiverse of Madness. Paramount Pictures had a $17 million opening starring Brad Pitt. From 2016, the movie was called Fury. Never mind. The enemy, Allied. We've had that one before. That's why it's in the brain somewhere. Okay, and then Paramount Pictures, third week. This must be Thanksgiving weekend because the legs on this are crazy. Starring Amy Adams, perhaps Arrival was in theaters around that time. It was. It was a pretty good day. I mean, this is like fairly recent, so the scores are going to be a little higher, but that was pretty good, man. Let's be honest, in the 2010s, you could have worse movies at the multiplex. Arrival's great. I'm fucking with Doctor Strange 1. I'm fucking more with Doctor Strange 2, though. They let Sam Raimi get his DNA all over it. And Moana, I mean, if you got a three-year-old, Moana is like basically as good as it gets. To be honest. Well, let's put it this way. It gets a lot worse. Moana's worth watching if you have a toddler. Now, the live action, I don't know. I'll probably get dragged to see it, but I'm cynical about it because I feel like it has no artistic reason to exist, but the animated movie's pretty good. What are we doing here? We got like 10, 15 minutes. Let's speed up and go to the ones that are fan favorites. BG Bandle? No. Emily Blunt. Denzel Washington. Denzel Washington, A to H, Q to Z, released from 05 to 2015. 05 to 2015, The Equalizer 2. The Equalizer. I'd like to restart. Title starts at A to H. Fucking Avatar, man. Title starts from Q to Z. I'll come up with something, okay? 2015 to 2005 to 2015. Let me think about it for a second. A to H, The Book of Eli. Q to Z, QRSTUV, WXYNZ. QRX, QRSTUV, WXYNZ. I mean, there's a lot. Let's go Training Day. It's going to be up there for sure. Emily Blunt. Edge of Tomorrow. Quiet Place Part 2. 2005 to 2015. Mary Poppins Returns, right? Mary Poppins Returns. Mary Poppins Goodbye. Mary. Devil Wears Prada. It could be Devil Wears Prada. That strikes me as an 05 jam. Yeah, okay. Nah, I give up. That's fine. That one stung, though. Star Trek, A Quiet Place. Never heard of it. Star Trek. Zoe Saldana, legit. She only does franchises, huh? Star Trek, Guardians of the Galaxy, The Avengers, and Avatar. I mean, more power to her, like, she's got to be, in terms of, like, wins above replacement, like, she's locked in, man. She's got to be, I don't know if you pick her number one in the fantasy draft of actors and actresses, but she's got to be up there. If you look at her advanced stats, like, how many whiffs does she have in, like, the last 15 years? She's a round one pick, is what I'm saying. Number one, who you taking? I don't know. It depends on the scoring, I suppose. Beef sandwich. Looks good. It's stacked a little high for me. Churrasco beef or Lomito pork? I'm going to just start with like Brazil because I've never seen this sandwich before. Southwest of Brazil, but doesn't border. Chile. There you go. We take those. It's very tall. But I'm not going to tell them how to make their sandwich. I've never even seen it before in my life. Now this originally looked horrible. Like it looked like somebody that was in the middle of healing from an injury But like now that I see that it's cheese and butter and bread, I'm into it. I'm going to say this is from France. I don't buy it, man. Really? United States of America? Where they eating this shit, man? The Gerber sandwich? St. Louis, Missouri. All right. Fair enough. It looks foul, but I would eat it for sure. I would love it if they could make it look like a little bit less like skin, but prawns, red chili peppers, kefir, lime leaves, lemongrass, shrimp paste. It looks like the kind of Thai food you don't get in a restaurant. Cool. Never mind, it's from Indonesia. Because it's always from Indonesia. It's note to self, it's never Thailand, it's always Indonesia. Looks good. I got nothing against it. We crush the average as usual. I don't hate Indonesia. I guess Indonesia like every day, man. I'm telling you, you're right, Gogi. This dull is a weapon wielded in the battle of cultural or culinary tourism. It's a culinary diplomacy psyop created by the government of Indonesia. Librarian, thank you for the gifted subscriptions. Thank you. Thank you. Let's be honest, we're going to need a pass on this one. Unless it's just Forrest Gump, because the picture is literally the lady on the bench. Alrighty. Easy enough. They gave it away, man. They gave it away for free. Your submission for kebab was accepted. Let's go. Your score has been updated accordingly. According to a dreary old song by Cream, the sun never shines in a white room with dark curtains. Yum! Eden Mess is a sloppy meringue and cream dish made with what summer fruit? Strawberries. The length of a meter is decreed by the International Bureau of Weights and Measures, located in what country? France? Oh! Because they called it a bureau instead of a department. We take those. Two bombs, one satellite project was launched by what 1960s leader? Nikita Khrushchev? No. It's Mao Zedong. The Great Leap Forward. That one stings. Italy's Olympic uniforms for the 2012 Games were designed by what dude under his EA7 label? Mario Andretti. Dude, Versace. Donna Versace's a lady. Karl Lagerfeld? I don't know. An eagle? It's Gucci, bro. Gucci was doing the uniforms. Never mind. Giorgio Armani. Oh, Giorgio Armani. I should know better than to ask chat for fashion advice, but I'm assuming there's like at least a couple of menswear guys in here. Is Armani good? Because I feel like I had a positive association with the brand, but now I only see middle-aged dudes on steroids wearing like the same black Armani Exchange t-shirt, and it's done irreparable damage to my brand awareness of Armani, even if it is two different things. There's a difference between the Exchange and the regular. Yeah, but like by the Exchange existing, doesn't that it causes the regular one to take a little bit of a brand hit, right? Like, I'm DL Guiga, are you here? I'm not a marketing expert. But it's like if Balenciaga was like, hey, we have got Balenciaga value, all of a sudden people aren't paying like $2,000 for a bag that looks like the IKEA blue bag anymore, right? They're going somewhere else. They're going to Celine or Yves Saint Laurent or something. We did pretty well, though. How'd we do today? 12 points. 12 points is pretty good. Okay, we got a couple more. What do we love to play? We love to play disorderly. Sort these countries by their foreign-born population as a percentage of their total population, starting with the highest. Okay, I feel like the UAE might have like 50% plus foreign-born population. I feel like the US and Australia are going to be 15-20%. Maybe 10. And then China, I'm assuming, is going to be relatively low. And Pakistan and Italy, I honestly just don't know. I think I'm going to send it like that. And then hot swap those. And the man's a stud. The man is a stud. What can I say, man? He knows heuristics. Yeah, 87, isn't that the reason that people don't want to go to Dubai? Is because, like, they basically fly in, like, servants to subsidize the lifestyle for the 12% of the people that were born there and also the tourists. I'm not familiar enough with the situation to use a term that's not servants, okay? Call Ludwig, he's crying. I will never go to Dubai, that's a given. Even before learning the problematic stuff, I was just like, it just doesn't... The tourism stuff that got the blue checks interested in going there never, like, it turned me off. I don't want a vending machine full of gold bars. What am I going to do? Walk up to the vending machine and be like, whoa, there's gold bars in that vending machine. What do I care? Oh, you can ski in the desert. I don't give a shit, man. But this is like a 19-hour flight or something like that. No thanks. Not interested. Yeah, I don't even like Las Vegas, man. And that's only like a 2.5-hour flight away. Okay. I mean, we got to do Fishtel. That's just a given. Barracuda. Barracude. I don't fuck with heart, honestly. Captain Planet. Throwing shade on the members of the Planeteers. Okay, I'm gonna say slash marker dolls.